I'm Elsie.
And I'm Debbie.
And we're two sisters Southern cooking. We are going to make some peanut butter filled chocolate eggs. That's one of our favorite Easter candies.
Yes.
That you pretty much, you only get the eggs at Easter, but you get the cups throughout the whole year, but it's pretty special. We have some silicone molds here. We're going to make our own.
Yeah.
So we're going to get started.
All right. And when we're done, this is going to sit in the freezer for about an hour, and then we're going to take it out, and then at that time, we're going to make our own chocolate, and we're going to dip them in chocolate, and then put them on parchment paper and let them dry, and then they'll be ready to eat tonight. So they're going to be good, y'all. So, this is going to be a sticky mess, guys.
So, we're putting our peanut butter in.
Here, I'm going to take that off for you because
peanut butter's sticky and you need the room.
By the way, hit the like button and subscribe, please. We love our followers. We think of you as family. We love your input. We love all of you engaging with us. And just, if you like what you see, follow us. We love you guys. And then the powdered sugar, I sifted. It's 3 cups. I sifted it because I don't want chunks of the confectioner sugar to be in the the inside of the peanut butter.
So just pour this in?
Absolutely. And we're gonna go ahead and put all of this, start whipping this up, and it's going to be very almost like clumpy, like almost like sand, wet sand. So, and that's when we're going to add in, and I warmed it up, 2 tablespoons of whole milk. Okay. We're going to start it out slow because of the powdered sugar. Yeah, and then we'll speed it up to be able to combine it. We may have to wipe down the sides of our bowl to get all the confectioner sugar in there. And I think we could probably add in
the milk.
So what we're going to do when we're done is we're going to take it and spoon it in here and level it off, and then we're going to let this sit up in the freezer for an hour, and once it sits up, then it hardens, and then we can come with
melted chocolate.
We put shortening in it. You can put like vegetable oil in it. We're going to put some shortening in it, and then we're going to dip them in and let them set up. It's going to be good, y'all. I'm going to get a little of like a ice cream scoop. This might be a little too large, but we can do like half of it, and
be a little much. You could try.
Okay.
Let me get this. And I'll use it to
press down.
Press down.
Almost like that.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
Mm-hmm.
This is very firm. It's not. But you need it to be firm because you need it to be able to hold up because it needs to hold a shape.
Right.
You can also do this in like if you have like little cookie cutters, You can also do that, roll it out like you would be dough, and that might need to be trimmed up a little bit. I'm pushing this together so it will make it a little easier to stick in here. And make sure your hands are clean.
Yeah.
Now you could do it, like I said, with a cookie cutter, but you need to roll it out like you're rolling out dough. Push it out, and then you can, like a half an inch, and then you can cut your shapes for your Easter eggs. So this is one of our Easter egg series. So we're going to be doing coloring Easter eggs soon. So we're going to be doing a plethora of things. I think might do some with marshmallows inside, some Easter eggs with marshmallows. I think that one would be really cool to maybe do something like that with this. And I think that would be a lot of fun. We could do that like a, almost like a mallow cup, but doing it with Easter eggs. Thomas is like Play-Doh.
Yeah.
It's the consistency of Play-Doh. So. So we got a lot to do. We'll come back and show you what it looks like when it's done. We'll be right back.
Hey y'all, we are back.
And guess what we are doing right now? We're going to take our chocolate. So what I ended up doing was about a 7.5 ounce bag of the semi-sweet and about, it was like 12 ounces, maybe a little bit more. I will let you know in the description box. I just eyeballed it. And then 2 tablespoons of shortening. And then we came up with, look at that. Beautiful. You know, our combination classically is the semi-sweet and the milk chocolate to make the best chocolates.
And look at this. Isn't that cute? It's so cute.
It is adorable. So as you see here, Elsie and I are both trying to
get our
eggs onto the, Elsie's doing it the freehand way, so she's going to be a little messy here. So I'm just draining my chocolate here. And then I'm gonna flip it over. These set pretty fast, so don't be alarmed. If you don't see your little designs, it's okay. Even though I would like for you guys to see that because I think that's so cute with the little lines and everything, so. All right, guys, we have one last one, and then we are going to go ahead and let these dry. Elsie's gonna take some, so you'll see her,
I'm actually gonna wash my hands real quick and then I can
She could take a plastic fork or a spoon or something and then she can just spoon it over top of them and just give them like a little gourmet look to them. All right guys, we will see you in our next video. You guys have a happy Easter. God bless and have a great night. Thank you.
I'm Elsie.
And I'm Debbie.
And we're two sisters Southern Cooking.
Please like, share, and subscribe.
Thank you.